Hello students, welcome to my channel Simply Biology. So today we are going to do term 2 chapter our environment. Let's begin. Environment means everything which surrounds us. It includes biotic, that is living component, and non-biotic, abiotic components. Water, air, plants, animals, they all are the part of our environment. Environment affects the life and development of an individual, an organism. Let's understand more. There are the substances which are decomposable by the bacterial action. They are called as biodegradable substances. Plant waste, cow dung, animal dead bodies, plant dead bodies, they are biodegradable. Some substances like plastic, DDT, fertilizers, they are not decomposable by bacterial action. So they are non-biodegradable waste or substances. These non-biodegradable substances, they remain persistent in the environment and they damage the ecosystem. We are here to see, we can see that there are two types of dustbin, green and blue. Green is for the biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste we have blue. So students, you should know that biodegradable waste, they do not harm the environment and they do not cause pollution. But on the other hand, your plastic, glasses, radioactive waste materials, they cause pollution. Ecosystem and its component. All the interacting organism in an area together with non-living component forms an ecosystem. So an ecosystem consists of both biotic, that is living, and abiotic, that is non-living component. So, the interaction of biotic with the abiotic component is called as ecosystem. Plants, animals, they are taking oxygen, water from the environment. So, that creates ecosystem. Abiotic components are like temperature, rain, wind and soil. So, ecosystem consists of both the components. Let's see various types of ecosystem. Man-made ecosystems are cropland, aquarium, your garden. Natural ecosystems are aquatic, terrestrial, you can see here, forest, grassland, desert. Land ecosystem is the forest. And here we can see the aquatic, marine and fresh lake. Ecosystems can be man-made and natural. Natural can be aquatic and can be terrestrial. Aquatic can be sea, oceans. Freshwater can be river, lake, pond. Terrestrials are forest, desert and grassland. So component of ecosystem are biotic and abiotic. Abiotic are water, land, air. Biotic are plants, animals. Plants, animals can be divided into further producers, consumers and decomposers. Consumers can be herbivores, carnivores, omnivores and parasites. Well, we can see that all living organisms, they are classified on the basis of the survived in the ecosystem. Producers, they are all green plant, blue green algae, they are the producers. Ye apna khana banate hain khud, with the help of process called photosynthesis. Consumers jo hain, wo consume karte hain producers se directly or indirectly. Like herbivores jo hain, wo grass eaters hain. Carnivores jo hain, wo flesh eaters hain. Omnivores, they feed on both plant and flesh. Consumers jo feed karte hain host body mein, unhe hum parasites kehte hain, like plasmodium and cuscuta. So consumers kya hain? Herbivores, carnivores, parasites and omnivores. Decomposers. Decomposers jo hain, they are fungi and bacteria. They decompose the dead plant and animal body into the simple components. Thus, decomposers helps in recycling of the natural components and they help in cleaning up the environment. So, we can see that the food chain, the herbivores, they are eaten up by carnivores and producers. दे आर फॉर्मिंग द बेस. सो ग्रास ग्रास को खा रहा है, डियर डियर को खा रहा है लायन. सो ये थ्री स्टेप फूड चेन है. सो फूड चेन इज बेसिकली, हियर यू कैन सी द प्रोड्यूसर्स, दे आर फॉर्मिंग द बेस ऑफ द फूड चेन पिरामिड, मोर इन नंबर. Then we have primary consumer, then we have secondary consumer, and we have tertiary consumers. So each step is called as trophic level. So first trophic level is producers, second trophic level is primary consumer, third trophic level is secondary consumer, and fourth trophic level is tertiary consumers. Plants can capture only 1% of sunlight. The flow of energy is unidirectional. That means the food taken up by the primary consumers from the producers, they cannot revert them back to the plants. There is gradual decrease in the amount of energy. That means only 10% of energy he transfer hogi to the next trophic level. 90% utilize ho jayegi in your different life processes mein, jaise ki metabolism, respiration and all. So bachcho, aaj ke liye itna hi. आपको पसंद आया मेरा वीडियो कंटेंट, डू लाइक शेयर फॉर मोर अपडेट्स. थैंक यू.